Hello there, fellow citizens. Today's topic is PvP in Star Citizen. Oh yeah, let me start this video with a short disclaimer. This is not meant as a clickbaity opinion piece and I try to stay as objective as possible. If my own views seep in here and there by accident, please be understanding. I definitely don't want to tell anyone how to play the game. Alright, now let's get going. I'm going to refer to the whole discussion about how PvP is supposed to work and try to break down the different opinions piece by piece, and at the end I try to propose a few possible solutions how Star Citizens could improve. We have a full spectrum of opinions here, going from a PvP free-for-all all the way over to turning off PvP completely. So I try to give an overview over this convoluted discussion and the individual points of frustration that it evoked. I will explain each argument and explain where it is coming from and why it's valid and shouldn't be disregarded immediately. As a personal favor, I ask you to stick till the end of the video and don't form your opinion before you heard each point. We start by looking at the side of the players that want to see a more restricted PvP experience. What do they want? What are their pain points? One term that is thrown around constantly is griefing, but the opinions of what this term encompasses differ extremely, which already gives us a hint at why this topic is controversial. It's just hard to define griefing. You can list a ton of examples and still not agree on what it actually means. The reason for that is that griefing is strongly determined by motivation and not so clearly by action. You could do the same exact things in two different situations and still only one would generally be seen as griefing. So why do people grieve? It mostly boils down to two motivators, exerting dominance and envy. You can increase your self-esteem by proving to yourself and others that you are better, or you can make other people suffer that might have a better time than you do to make you feel better. Both these motivations are regarded as selfish and immoral by the larger part of society, as they enhance the happiness of one individual at the cost of another. So I hope we can agree on not wanting that kind of behavior in our game. The aforementioned issues arise when you try to judge actions without knowing about their motivation. And as we don't have a motivation lock, akin to a chat lock or something, we struggle to agree on whether the behavior was griefing or if the player might have had actually good reasons to kill another player in that specific situation. Next point on the list, and more of an actual discussion point, is that some players don't want to be forced to partake in combat against other players. If we can accept that people tend to be very different, how they feel comfortable interacting with other human beings, we can see where they are coming from. I mean, nobody wants to be forced to do something they don't enjoy, right? Though I'd argue that this is not as black and white as some people try to make it look. The frequency and intensity of the PvP interactions do make a difference. Some people enjoy a quick PvP fight here and there, but want to play mostly by themselves. Others want to do nothing else if possible. Now you could argue, if you don't enjoy playing the game, why not play something else? But this argument loses a lot of its power the more non-PvP elements are part of the game. It's also not a good solution for someone that would really love to play Star Citizen for the most part to feel forced to miss out on that great game. And in general, you can say that a bit of inclusion for these players can go a long way to a healthy player base, and who knows, probably quite a few of these players might convert to do some PvP in the future once they feel more confident knowing the game. The last argument I've noted for this side is that PvP should be fair, that it's no fun to fight with a nomad against a hammerhead. People sometimes refer to this as a kind of griefing as well, but I think the argument comes from the notion that PvP should be a test of skills, that you should earn victory and not just win by having the odds stacked in their favor. This sentiment is actually shared quite often from the people that do love to engage in PvP, but coming from the competitive side, where twitch reaction and tactical skills are regarded above all other. They prefer to compete with set rules, matchmaking, and on even ground. Now let me switch over to the other side, arguing for less restrictions or keeping PvP rather unregulated as it is today. Currently in the game, it's already hard to find situations where you can attack and fight against other players. Some players from the PvP community are worried that if you allow players to turn off PvP completely, it will become even harder to find an enemy to engage with. Rightfully so. Gone are the days of Jumptown, where you could almost count on finding prey or becoming the hunted yourself if you didn't pay attention. For those who don't know, Jumptown was a location where you could make a lot of money, which lured a lot of players outside the armistice zones. Moreover, you can also argue that it makes the game more interesting and less predictable when you are in constant danger, and players would act against their own interest if they turned PvP off just because they are a bit risk-averse, depriving themselves from a great and suspenseful experience. And in a similar way, players might just not enjoy PvP because they don't take part in it, and even though the initial experience might be off-putting, they might get better and enjoy themselves after some time. Something that might not have happened when they didn't even participate in the first place. And lastly, isn't space just a dangerous place? Doesn't the feel of imminent danger drive immersion? Isn't the game more realistic that way? Well, forgive me to insert an opinion here, I think that's a rather weak argument. That solely depends on the world building, and you can create a world as real and immersive where you're not being able to attack everyone, and that can be integrated very naturally. Also, you're still comparing a game with the real world, and that's just a flawed point of view from the beginning. I mean, in real life we are not shooting each other regularly at least, because death is a rather harsh consequence compared to virtual death in a video game. But I digress. As you might have already noticed, there are many arguments on multiple sides and they all have valid points. So, is Star Citizen doomed to disappoint everyone and fail? Well, no, of course not. Diversity doesn't mean chaos necessarily, but it does require compromise and a bit of empathy. Okay, while writing this script, I came to the conclusion that I have to do a two-parter for this video. Sorry, but my ideas on how to resolve these issues, or at least improve upon them, have to wait for another time. I hope you did enjoy this video, and if you did so, give it a like and consider subscribing my channel. There's lots of cool stuff to come. And with that, see ya!